Hey everybody, welcome back to Darkest Dungeon. My name is Baer. We've got some options today, a lot of really good ones in fact, considering no one's really hurting too bad. Not a lot of stress piled on anybody. I guess I could, well, no, really, there's no one I'd like to commit, so that's a great feeling. No disease either, hooray. Maybe worth it to address some quirks then. I have had that opportunity recently, and you know what, that seems like a good idea. Let's get some of these higher level people taken care of a little bit better. So let's get, let's look at Reynald and Dismas first of all. I know that these guys are going to be involved in basically the majority of whatever we do from this point moving forward. So Thanatophobia is pretty bad. I could get rid of this. It's really expensive. But is there anything I like to do here? Let's see. Beast Hater is pretty good as well. That is so much money. Oh my god. I don't know about this anymore. I guess I need to spend some bus and crest to upgrade this to reduce the treatment cost pretty considerably, right? I could do that. I think it's probably worth it. That makes it a lot cheaper already. Maybe that saves me enough. Is Thanatophobia bad enough? That is a significant debuff, so I think I'm going to go ahead and get rid of that. I'm going to make Reynald a goddamn champion. And then those two are fine. I can leave those locked in, no problem. Let's have a look at our Vestal here. Tippler's okay. Kophobe is pretty bad. That'd be a lot cheaper to get rid of now. I could consider it. It's not really that awful, though. Let's have another look around here. Demonomania is considerable. Misses the spot. Pretty bad. I would get rid of that, but it is locked in already, so pretty expensive already. Didn't I actually imagine we're going to be bringing out into this next dungeon, so I'll leave her be for now. Clumsy is pretty nasty. All right, you know what? Let's go ahead and get rid of that. Let's do this one. And do I want to lock in any of these? Probably not. All right, that'll do. Cool. All right, that is some, like, advanced stuff we're getting taken care of today, so that's a good feeling. And we can also address some camping skills, but first let's build our party and see where we're actually going to go today. And I'm pretty sure it's going to be to the ruins. So we've got a couple of long dungeons that we could choose from today. We've got this one here in the cove. Oh, actually just the one. Okay, so yeah, it's just the cove one. But that would be, of course, an apprentice level dungeon, which would mean we'd have to bring out the exact same team, which we could do. I really feel pretty good about that, actually, but well, you know what? Now that I think about it again, that might very well be what I do here, because I'd love to get the protective collar for the Houndmaster. That's pretty good. I could sell it if nothing else. There's 9 crests, a lot more experience for these guys. I gotta level them up eventually, so fuck it. Yeah, let's do it now. I'm okay with this. And we've basically got this is all set up already. We're good to go. Alright, yeah, let's do it. Long Cove mission, I like it. I was considering the activate 3 corrupted altars, considering the town events now apparently are a lot more valuable to me. The alternative missions have a lot more appeal as a result of that, which makes me really happy. Again, I am so glad that they made that change, because that is a welcome adjustment to those encounters. I don't need these. I don't know why I'm buying those. We're going to the cove, so we need some bandages. I'll grab 2 keys. I imagine we'll probably end up using those. And of course, no antiquarian here, as I thought we might have, but not really an issue. I'm going to grab 2 just in case, and then 4 shovels. We'll call that good. This is a lot of stuff, but I think we need it. Into the cove with the same team that we rocked the Casbah with last time. Felt really nice to get through another Shambler kill, too. That felt great. These soul-soaked
caverns are teeming with pelagic nightmares. They must be flushed out.
Oh my god. Okay, well, this is an exterminate as well, so this is going to be, I think this is going to be considerably more difficult than the previous expedition. I think we're going to run into a little bit of trouble here, in fact. This is going to be a little bit more daunting. Exterminations, of course.
The path is clear. We require only the strength to follow it.
You know, generally going to be a lot more difficult to deal with, so that's kind of obvious, but this is the cove. And the damage over time, like, I'm really glad, actually, that I brought 6 bandages, and we have battlefield medicine, too. You know what? The Plague Doctor is actually going to be marvelous here. I hadn't even thought about that. This party is even better. The Houndmaster is debatably, like, the weakest character, but even then, he reduces protection on some of these characters that I know can give me a big issue if I don't whittle away their defenses more quickly.
Decimated.
And obviously, that went pretty damn well. So, yeah, you know, feeling okay. There we go. Good shit. Let's just go ahead and fill up. That's fine. That's fine. Good stuff. I think I ought to consider bringing out an antiquarian again pretty soon here, though. This is the eye of the storm here, I think. No, hold on. Oh, boy. You gotta die. The leper will probably take care of you. Stun doesn't help, right? So, stunning this one does. Yeah, no, if we can do it, right? If that'll work. Hey, alrighty. I'm gonna go ahead and just commit to this. I need to make sure this doesn't happen. There we go. Alright. That's fine. I was a lot more worried about this fight than I probably ought to have been, but I was fearful of the stuns that could take place. The surprise was certainly helpful there. I think we're gonna be okay. Use the whistle again, reduce the protection, make it a lot easier for the leper here, unless he gets stunned. Yep. Oh boy. So many ailments, so many afflictions. Goodness. We want to stun again here. I think I'm gonna heal. Honestly, I wanna play this really safe. I'm gonna overestimate the capabilities of these foes. This is still an apprentice level dungeon, of course, but I really do feel like we could be caught off guard pretty quickly here. Especially if I happen to let a gargler get up and explode uninterrupted. That could, destroy them all. Clearly and quickly evaporate my chances of success here, but obviously we're fine thus far.
The slow death, unforeseen, unforgiving.
I think I'm gonna get rid of this. No, you know what? Yeah, it's the cove. I think I gotta keep those for now. And then, yeah, let's just do that. Gotta keep those. I'm gonna prioritize the crests. Most of the heirlooms, in fact. I'm pretty sure I need to start making those a higher priority. Holy fuck! Oh, thank goodness. Okay. Another really convenient surprise here. So let's just stun everybody. We'll get the blackjack off on the front grouper and double stun on the back, ideally. Which is pretty great. This is effectively what the former version of the party surprise used to be back in the early access days. Used to be when you got a surprise attack on the enemy, they got to skip an entire friggin' turn. They didn't even get to act at the end. This is all just bonus to them. See, they wouldn't even get this stun resistance till next turn, man. They wouldn't even know what hit them. Speaking of which, boop.
Formation is broken. Maintain the offensive.
Now, sadly, of course, that means these guys are more than likely going to get a lot of damage off because I didn't actually hurt them in any meaningful way, and that certainly was an example of that. Oh, god damn it, one damage. Cost me 8. Jeez, that sucks. All right, a group heal is certainly appealing here, but I could also just kill you. Healing the Vestal simultaneously and reducing stress. I look like a genius. I suppose that does work out for me to get rid of their stun resistance ahead of stunning them again. That sort of did the job. Glad I reserved my dog biscuit there, too. I was considering it for a brief moment, but I'm pretty sure we're going to be okay here. I don't have Purge equipped, goddammit. All right. Withstand, I guess. Although they're not going to attack him, so that sort of sucks. Oh, yeah, I think I'm going to have to switch off Withstand for Purge, at least for now. While I don't have to deal with stress, I think I should take that move off, because I very rarely actually just want a protection bonus. That doesn't really happen that often. Let's keep you alive and well. Keep things ship-shape here. Ship-shape! Like a boat pun! Oh, boy! Oh, we had been... We'd been losing out on the humor. What with all the murder going on? Thank God you dodged that. Holy shit, we are taking a lot of damage here. I think the blood is enough to kill him now. He's got... Okay, yeah, we're good to go. So let's try just embarrassing them with the amount of damage they have to deal with instead of healing, because, you know, that would have been better. Would have been a much better option for me, but sadly wasn't available. Or it would have been available, I guess, but minimally effective. Wow. They really want me to keep taking turns here, huh? That's fine, I guess. And we'll just heal. Yeah, jeez. I mean, all these useless maneuvers. Makes me feel better. Goddamn, what the hell? Yay. This is so convenient. Thank you.
Gently.
Really?
This is how a life is taken.
We get to take every single heal imaginable. That's nice.
This expedition at least promises success.
And we clear this out and we are good to go. Okay. Man, the early goings here have been pretty goddamn eventful, huh?
Wealth beyond measure. Awarded to the brave and the foolhardy alike.
Alright, please tell me somebody isn't gonna interact with this against my will here, because we have some really gnarly stuff I'd love to get rid of on these guys. And I don't think it's gonna be the Plague Doctor. Diurnal really doesn't make that big of a difference either. These two are pretty awful. Him going up against beasts is not looking good right now, so I would really love to get rid of this, yes. Thank you! Thank you very much. Alright, that's the stress. Unfortunately, Fear of Beasts is still on him, and that's still a bad one. Oh, boy. Oh, well. No spiders, please. No spiders. No beasts of any variety, of any sort, really. If you can avoid it. Like, he's not a beast, so yeah, he's fine. Keep bringing the surprise attacks, too. Come on down with those. All aboard the Surprise Attack Express. Population R team. Damn it. I think I want to kill you.
Obliterated.
Sorry, I mean, like, it's nothing personal. It just seems strategically valuable. And there we go. Everybody's nearly back up to full health again, apart from you, who I'm ignoring. Alright, that's fine. That gives us a party heal still, and she gets to be targeted by everything now, which is an added bonus. Good stuff there. Yep! He really does not hit that hard, man. Even with the crescendo box, he's... He is just not the strongest team member, unfortunately. I think the Grave Robber even may deal more damage than he does. He's got more utility, of course, but... I'm thinking about maybe trying to grab one of those out of the stagecoach at some point here. I've got the Houndmasters and the Man-at-Arms set as a pretty high priority in my head. And I think that's still accurate, but... At the same time, a Grave Robber is quite nice. That should do it. There we go. I'll go ahead and get rid of the bleed here, I guess. That seems logical. And yeah, sure. Keep having zero stress, buddy.
Great is the weapon that cuts on its own.
All right, I remembered. Hold on. I'm going to get rid of that thing. We're still going to prioritize the crest seer, and I want that money, though. Damn it. Damn it, damn it, damn it. It's too much stuff in the inventory, man. I'm gonna have to camp out really soon here. Oh, we have a lot of torches too, don't we? You know what? I don't need that many.
May we find victory.
That's too much. That's over-preparedness. And now we're gonna do this. Here we go. Hey, he doesn't have Purge unlocked. Alright, never mind. Doesn't matter. Just keep that same stuff. I didn't care. No, that's what I wanted. It's exactly what I wanted. Let's go down here. Couple of thralls! Another surprise! What in the fuck? Did I break the game? What is happening? How are we surprising every enemy? This is nonsense. I feel like I'm cheating. I probably am. Must have left the hacks turned on. Those off-cam hacks that I always enable. You know how I am. Got to impress the stream crowd, man.
A death by inches.
Okay, you gotta go. And they deal, like, a good amount of damage and stress just with their normal attacks, too. These guys are considerably more powerful than your average enemy. I'm really glad they don't have protection or anything like that. Otherwise, I feel they'd maybe be a touch OP. Like, imagine a group of these. Jesus, that'd be horrifying. All right, they're both down. Let's go ahead and withstand now that it's actually useful. And hopefully heal here, maybe? Yeah, baby! Nice. That'll do.
Success so clearly in view. Or is it merely a trick of the light?
Nah, I think we're good, man. 25 gold, a little bit of extra here.
Glittering gold, trinkets and baubles. Paid for in blood.
Give me emptiness. Give me, a guardian and some groupers and a shaman, huh? Just the whole fucking fish family on board. And the stress is getting to scary levels here, so let's start being smart. I'm gonna start plague-grenading the fuck out of them in the back line. Probably want to start focusing on the healing again, too. Now that that's taken place, now that that's transpired. Oh! Bersigni with the counter! Muy bueno! Mark him down, reduce that protection. Let's go ahead and get this started. Look at all those marks and dashes, man. That name's impossible to pronounce. No one was ever meant to say this word aloud. That's just ignorant. Ooh, good dodge. That's fine, that's fine. Even if he blocks the play grenade, I'm totally fine with that. I need some damage over time on this motherfucker, too. Yeah, big boy, you want some? Mm-hmm. And I can even stun him. You know what? That gets rid of the protection. I'm okay with that. Sure thing, chicken wing. Let me kill you off, too. Oh, come on now. Come on now. Come on and slam. Welcome to the jam. Still play grenading. Ideally killing you before you get to act. There we go. Not too shabby. Prevents the heal. And if I land this with 2 damage, that does... it's not enough. Alright, so I guess we just want to do this then. And we can't hit you with anything that's really going to matter. I guess if I judgment again, although I really want to heal now. And I'm pretty sure I'm going to. You might be dead. You are dead. Wow, that's great. Yeah, let's heal it up. Fine by me. Your stress is becoming a problem. Really quickly. I'm wondering if I should maybe consider switching this up so I can have him use his stress heal. Brought low and driven into the mud. That's probably unnecessary, though, and I don't think I'm going to take either of these. Let's just leave them be. And let's camp now. Should I? No, I don't think I should. I'm going to let the torchlight die down a little bit. We'll come back to grab that chest later when we have more inventory space. And, yeah, that'll do. Maker's art. His efficacy unwitnessed by his own eyes. So yeah, let's let the torchlight go away, as I mentioned. I'll go ahead and interact with the syphilis stone. Naturally, it gave me syphilis. And a weak grip on life. Those are basically the same thing. Oh, that's terrible. That's not, don't reduce the life of someone with an STI. Oh god, that's... What is happening? All the surprise! I shouldn't complain. But holy shit. It's kind of crazy, and I'm loving just stunning everybody with this being the opportunity we're presented to. And getting the torchlight out of it to boot. Alright, sweet. The whole team stunned again. Oh, that's so fun. That's so fun. And now I get to murder you before you explode. Right? 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 No. No, I don't. Oh, boy. Okay. Oh, now I'm worried about it. Oh, shit. Let's just go ahead and make sure that happens with the leper's shot. Because that's scary. Oh, I really don't want you to blow up. Please don't blow up. Can I just... There we go. Okay, he's dead. I was really worried sick about that. I was pretty damn sure he was gonna find a way. Oh, good stuff. Nice dodge, too. Okay, this is starting to look up. It's starting to look down. What goes up must completely collapse into nothingness. It doesn't really make sense. That does, though. That makes a hell of a lot of sense. Oh, this is... Now, okay, this is campfire time. I've gotta prevent the resolve checks, man. Like, I was mentioning earlier, I really am in the eye of the storm here, where I feel like I'm invincible. I feel like nothing can go wrong, no harm can befall me. And that is a bad mindset to be in this game. Y'all know that. Y'all don't need me to tell you that. Trickle down. Trickle down economics, boy. Yeah, sure. I really should be taking those opportunities. I squander them occasionally. 2 health can make a difference.
A trifling victory. but a victory nonetheless.
This seems worth it to keep. I really wish I could, but I don't think I can. If I prioritize the heirlooms like I said I would, but that's 1,100 gold! God damn it, that's a lot of money. Oh man, this sucks. I guess it's worth it to dump these in favor of the money, right? But then if I get two more emeralds, I look like a doofus. I'm gonna take this over the crest. It seems like the better idea. And now I definitely want to camp out.
A moment of respite. A chance to steel oneself against the coming horrors.
Alright, well, I guess I might as well continue to encourage this happening. It's been working quite well. Therapy dog seems nice. Could also encourage the plague doctor is a totally valid choice. Reflection, unfortunately, doesn't help that much. Quarantine is pretty good. I think I'll do this. Oh, I should have done the I missed that ancestor's bottle trick again there. I really should have done that. That's a silly thing. Okay, I think I might just go therapy dog and courage here. I like it. Not bad. That's a lot of stress reduced. I like it.
The match is struck. A blazing star is born.
And a hidden compartment. Awesome. All right, inventory's full again. Let's go.
A fortune waiting to be spent.
So I've been mentioning a couple of times how happy I am about the fact that they've changed those.
Such missteps are the exception, and not the rule.
They've changed the parameters of those other missions of the activate the corrupted altars, of the cleanse the infected corpses, all that shit, so that the town events are a lot better as a result of them. And I don't know if that happens every time. I don't imagine it does. But I kind of hope it does, actually. Because that's really cool. And it really opens up my mind to the possibilities of, like, what else we could do with that, you know? There's a lot more to be built from this foundation that Darkest Dungeon has. There's a lot more you could expand out. Like, a lot more areas, obviously. Areas and characters are the natural first ideas that come to mind. But it's beyond that, like, the interactions of stuff. Like, thinking as far as saying, like, the amount of curios you interact with maybe having an effect on the estate, you know? Or prioritizing certain sorts of gems in order to get benefits somewhere. Anything like that. Like, it's really exciting. Oh, I didn't even realize that was happening, but okay. Yeah, I was wondering how much you guys are theory crafting about stuff like that. What sort of ideas you had for expanding the world of the dungeon. Because I still, like, I know it's hard for some folks to believe for some reason, but I still really love playing this game. Like, every time I get on to play this for YouTube, I still am having a blast. So I'm looking forward to potentially seeing more of it. And I know they've got plans, too. I know Red Hook has a ton of plans for future content, so that's equally encouraging. Alright, we're doing fine now. A campfire put me in a much better place, and we are— oh, man! Wow! Good shot!
Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer.
I think I'm gonna go ahead and use this. I may regret it. It often ends up that the long dungeons provide secret rooms, so I very well could come to regret that. My god, this dungeon has been long. Like, there's been so many fights over here. I feel like every room was a room battle. And we're doing okay still. I mean, like, health and stress-wise, we're good, but we're very quickly running low on food supplies, and the torches are also sort of alarming, but also not that bad. Okay, we got a little extra box over here, too, to investigate. How long does this last, this buff, for the... Oh, it's three combats more. Okay, so we got plenty of time on that. Yay! Alright, we got one anti-venom as well. I gotta remember that's free inventory space to clear up. We also got the two dog biscuits that I'll eventually use. Or forget to use. What's more likely? Probably the latter. Sadly enough. We're good, though. This team is rock solid, actually. Even better in the cove, as we mentioned. Houndmaster, obviously not as ideal. But still quite good. And off we go. Crests are good. No herbs. It's alright. That's alright. That's alright. We get a nice little lull here. Nice little break from the action. The promise of safety. And then into two cutthroats and fusiliers. Holy shit, man. Alright, I am tempted to go ahead and pop the dog treat. This one seems like a good opportunity, because this is a ton of potential damage here. These guys are frightening. And that bleed's not going to be enough, so I think I'm just going to go ahead and finish him off. It's fine with me. She's no longer as effective. I think I'll have to use a Noxious Blast on one of the frontliners. Good to resist that debuff, at least. Uh-huh! Yep, that's why we Dog Biscuit. I'm just gonna... Should I Battlefield Medicine? It's really not that strong, and I think the Noxious Blast damage is a lot more valuable. We may even be able to kill him before he acts if the Leper goes first. Nice! Oh, that might be oh, I think it's one off! Of course! Of course! 5 damage. Alright, well, at least he's done next turn, so I'm really glad we chose the Noxious Blast there. We can also Battlefield Medicine this to be able to get rid of it on both of them, so that's nice. Minimal damage there. I think we'll Judgment again if I get the opportunity. Definitely gonna do this. I could heal. It's probably a better idea. I've still got one campfire as well. I gotta remember that. Good dodge. Very nice. And we'll, hopefully get the kill. Nope. Total opposite. Yeah. Ow. Oh, god damn. This is getting bad. Ouch. Oh, this is the battle that turned it around for me. In a bad way. Here's hoping it's not really the case. Okay, you still need some help, so let's just go ahead and finish you off before you get the extra shot in. I could stun you. That seems wise, but I also really need to heal. Oh, good stuff. Well done, McCault. Hell yes. And now... I may withstand here. He's the likely target. But then again, he also might get the kill. That's what I was afraid of. That's what I was afraid of. Damn it. Luckily, it's not too bad still, but... This is still... I mean, like, we've got a long way to go here, man. I really don't want to start putting myself in this position early on. So here's hoping we get some good heals at least out of these last couple of rounds. Nice! Oh my god, McCault! Coming in clutch right here. I like it. And some stress relief to boot. Okay. Not too bad. See, you, however, Bersigni, are sort of choking. Just a little bit of... I think I need to self-heal with our Houndmaster too, honestly, and let's just do this. Alright, he's dead. There we go. There we go, okay. Holy shit.
As victories mount, so too will resistance.
Let's see here. This is a room battle, we know that, right? Yeah, goddamn, man! Another surprise attack though, luckily, jeez. Oh, that has been magnificent. Alright, so we're not gonna go full stun this time. I think I'm actually gonna go damage first. Let's do, let's focus down the Shaman ideally, and the Plague Grenade sadly isn't gonna be enough for that, but I'll still do it. Or is that enough? Oh, that's so close! God damn it! And one damage away from the jellyfish, too! This is ridiculous. Utterly ridiculous! Okay, so he's done next turn, so long as he doesn't heal himself, which it doesn't look like he will. He does get the stress off, but that's okay, it's manageable. Little extra too, good dodge, thank you! And here comes the physical damage. Not too bad, right? Not too bad. Okay. Houndmaster self-heal is becoming more and more appealing here, but I still have enemies I need to deal one damage to, unfortunately, and he could very well take care of that. I think I need to, yeah. I really wish I could lick wounds, but I'd much rather get rid of the damage. This is scary shit! Yes, indeed! Very nice nautical pun there as well, Wayne. Appreciate that. If I hit this, that means he's dead. And she's the only one that's going to be able to do that, and I'd like to prevent his physical damage next turn, so let's go ahead and make that happen. Start whittling away at you, and get the heals going. Because I know the Houndmaster can heal himself and is likely to do so next turn, because the Leper, I'm pretty sure, is going to be able to take care of him one-on-one. I think we'll get self-healing going almost across the board here. We'll get some Battlefield Medicine, we'll get some group heals, probably just a self-heal on, or a focused heal on the Plague Doctor. Battlefield Medicine on the Leper is fine. self-heal from the Houndmaster. This guy's already dead. Nice! Good stuff! Alright. That turned out pretty well. Good dodge, too. Okay. How quickly the tide turns! That was unnecessary, but I wanted to do it anyway. Sometimes you just gotta go for it. And I think I may even judgment here. I think I could probably get away with that. It doesn't really help that much anymore, though. Yeah, I'd rather heal. I'd rather heal it up. Especially on our Plague Doctor. She's still pretty low. There we go. Much better. Oh my god, that feels so much better. Okay, let's just fucking murder you. He's already done. Another heal. Beautiful. Oh my god, I love it. I love it!
These nightmarish creatures can be felled. They can be beaten.
Oh, great scout. Okay, here we go. Give me the goods. What do you got? I knew it'd be there! Damn it! Oh, do we have a key? We don't have a key. Alright, we absolutely need to get a key. Let's see here. What do I want to get rid of? I think I'll just dump this off. We'll see what we get out of the statue. Inspiration! Very nice. Desperately want to find a key now. And make the long, arduous trek back to the secret room on the far end. You got 100% guaranteed stress relief here. Gotta like that. No herbs, but we'll take the chance, I think. Only digested fish. Well, only digested fish. That's a negative attitude. You know how many things you can do with digested fish? Few. If any. You like, I don't know. Stuff a hole. Oh, God. Don't be a little more general there, Bear.
A decisive pummeling.
General Bear there. That was a fun sentence. Okay, let's kill you. That is enough, right? Oh, with the bleed it would have been. God damn it. God damn it. One damage. We need someone on the team who at all times can just deal one damage to each party member. And that's probably the Houndmaster, isn't it? Yeah, that's his... That's his fucking... Mercy, or what is that thing called? Hound's Harry, that's what that's called. Maybe I should equip that. I think I might want to equip that again. What would I replace? I've been using Blackjack a few times, I guess. I have been reducing protection, albeit a lot less than I expected to. I could replace Target with... Yeah, that's not bad. Target Whistle replaced with Hound's Harry? Considerable. Not here. Obviously not in the cove, but in the future, perhaps. Perhaps, just maybe, we go back to the Hound's Harry. Could happen. For now, though, these guys are just wrecking shit. No disease. Thank you. Alright, just a little bit more healing on the Plague Doctor, and we are good to go. Let me get that big swang. Let me get that big swang from the leper here. That'll work. Yeah, we get the heal off too. Schmaxy. Love it.
Seize this momentum.
Nah.
Push on to the task's end.
More fish guts, yeah! Alright! Oh man, I'm getting stoked on all this digested fish we're finding. Real exciting stuff. And another shovel, there we go.
Another mariner, another misfortune.
Oh my goodness, so many fights in this dungeon, man! Holy shit! It's getting ridiculous! Alright, you're clearly the target then, let's just do this. Oh hey, you're gonna get buffed? Let me immediately focus all of my attacks on you!
Unbalanced.
God damn it. Wow, they're going kinda quick here too. Oh, goodness. I still love the way that he just fucking takes it, you know? He's a champ, man. It's like, yeah, hit me, bitch! What do you got? My limbs are falling off. You can't even touch me. You can't hurt my pride. Yeah, this makes sense. I mean, you can't fucking bring him back from the dead, right? It's not like you got a mercy ult in your back pocket or something. Huh? How about that Overwatch reference? Yeah, I know that game. Yeah, I've played 40 hours of that game. Yeah, I'm streaming that game on twitch.tv/beartaffy if you didn't realize. Very frequently, in fact. FYI. I am very happy with our present health situation here. In fact, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and use a bandage there. Let's dump off this corpse into the unknown and clear the way for some good old-fashioned hound mastering. And a little bit more of that, too.
Devastating blow.
Yes, indeed. Oh, yes. Good stuff. And we don't get it.
Be wary. Triumphant pride precipitates a dizzying fall.
I am beginning to believe that's not going to happen, man. I got to be honest with you. I think we're going to be okay.
As the light gains purchase, spirits are lifted, and purpose is made clear.
I'm even beginning to consider the possibility that we'll make it through this. We probably won't get the secret room, if I'm being real with you guys. I don't imagine we're going to be able to get back there with a key and fulfill my ancestors' wishes. You know what? This is a good opportunity to do this. But, luckily, I believe we are still going to make it through this without too much further difficulty. So optimism there. And we've handled, a good amount of these sorts of fights up to this point without taking too much damage. We've been able to heal it up relatively easily. That's pretty good. That's pretty good right there. Let's go ahead and judgment. Oh, baby!
And power.
That's nice. And the combo moves, like, look at this, the leper and the plague doctor, I was about to say, are going to combo to kill this guy, but obviously not going to happen. Still, though, like a ton of damage from every member of the team now. Feels pretty sweet, man. No bleed. All right, you need one more. And you got 13. A 1 plus a 3. And there's the 1. This has just been beautiful. Oh, I should have used that on something else. Yeah, that was silly. I just saw what that did. Bad response. Oh, my God. But it doesn't end here, does it? Not to mention, I am a little concerned now about the fact that I don't have enough food to camp out properly, so that sort of sucks. Oh, goddammit.
Cruel machinations spring to life with a singular purpose.
I should have let the Houndmaster do that one, too. I'm slipping, man. I'm slipping at the end. What is happening? How is that? It's blowing my mind at this point. The amount of surprise attacks we've managed in here is ridiculous. All right, no more dog biscuits, unfortunately, but we do still very much want to kill the guys in back. Still not going to be enough there, but then we'll take him out in turn two. Let's kill you. You're more of a nuisance than you have any right to be, really, so let's try to take you out first. He gets the buff off before giving his life for the party. Doesn't even heal himself. Look at this team player. He's in it to win it, man. Sadly, they are just really screwed. So the odds are stacked heavily against you guys. No disease. Thank you. You just gotta ask nice every time. It works. Totally works. All right, you're done. Very good. Let's start this off. And a leopard to boot. There we go. You are dead, right? Yeah, that's 5. Okay, very nice. Keep the heels up. We are loving it. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Oh, I'm going to get sued now. Shit. They have, like, they actually have a trademark on that sequence of 5 syllables. I wonder if they do. They might. They might. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. They might have trademarked that. Somebody look that up for me. I'm curious. I'll do it. No, I'll do it later, but, you know, like, you can do it now if you want. Is that scummy? I can't decide. If they, like, I'm already assuming that they've done it, but if they have, I don't know whether or not that's a bad thing. Who knows? Is it up to me to decide? Probably. I'm the one commentating. I am God here. This is my... Oh, God. Now I'm getting a God complex about it. This is really turned around. Well, all right. Well, we know we have at least one more room battle here, and it's gonna be right there. Still haven't found that precious key either, have we? Sadly, void of any- Oh wait, hold on, more digested fish though, yes! Oh, baby! I'm gonna call this episode Digested Fish, and people are gonna be like, what the fuck, man? He is really running out of creative juices for those episode titles, to tell you what. Okay, entering the darkness here now, unfortunately. Attempted to almost use a campfire just to get that light back up, but probably gonna be okay. Especially here. But we do need to heal a considerable amount still, so tell you what, let me get a stun off, actually. That's probably gonna help us out a considerable amount, and then maybe even kill you. Start getting this dude down. I think I'll try to knock you out with the leper. Actually, no, our better play is to try to kill this one. Counter that with a little bit of healing. Take you out. There we go. That would have killed you, but that's okay. That's just fine. Houndmaster, the stun is still good and still a really good chance to land as well. He's got the bonus with the stun amulet, so that's nearly a guarantee. He's out of the picture and will be dead next turn, too. All right, sweet. That worked out. And now I probably want to even just stress heal with the leper. Or I could try to clear out. Yeah, you know what? Let's get rid of the corpse. That moves him forward. And we can heal up. Splendid! Little by little bit, we're making this wonderful. And that's- oh my god, they still hit so hard. That should be the last of it. So I'm gonna take this small opportunity to, get more heals going, get the damage over time, start to apply, and then you need one more hit! God damn it, of course! I'm gonna take a chance here. Please don't move first. Please don't move first. Thank God. Goodbye. Maybe even get us another heal off? Another heal off? Yeah! Yeah, one health. Totally worth it. Oh my goodness. So much shit. I am go- I really don't want to chance this, but I'm gonna do it. I think the Onyx is more worth it, and let's, yeah, we don't need these. I think I've been fine without them. There we go. Into the darkness. Don't be too bad. Oh, that is sort of a scary one, actually. So let's make sure these guys are gonna go down real quick so we can make sure all the damage is coming up to the front here. You're probably not dead as a result of that. Or you are. Oh, pardon me. I should not have assumed. Oh, God.
For the slightest lapse in concentration.
Ow. Okay. Oh, that's gonna be a lot, too, because we're in the darkness. All right, 21. That's not so bad. And no, oh, Jesus. I need his self-heal so bad right now. Holy shit. I really should have equipped that a long time ago, but I don't even have it. I just remembered. Yeah, he's only got 4 skills unlocked. I probably should have checked into that. I also think I could have upgraded all these guys in the blacksmith before I left, too. Jeez, I really just did not want to put myself in a good spot to win here, did I? Luckily, they're not trying to murder him. Now they are. Oh, God.
Breath from becoming unwound.
Oh, God, yeah. So let's, I should heal him first, right? No, I think we're fine. I know the Vestal's gonna act, so there's guaranteed healing to come. I think we'll be okay. Jesus. That got a little scary though, man. God damn. I think I should have probably stunned this guy. I don't know. I don't even know at this point. Let's just finish this off. Come on, let me do it first. There we go. Very nice. Alright, man. Ooh, that's a lot of money though. Alright, so. I think we can leave this be. I want all this stuff. Maybe the crest, but no. There we go. Very nice. Okay, still didn't get a key out of this. Might get one out of the chest, you never know.
Huddled together, furtive and vulnerable. Rats in a maze.
Alright, so if I do Sanctuary here, then he's gonna recover a ton of health, get rid of all that stress. prevents the ambush, so I think I will take this. We'll do therapy dog and encourage again to get rid of most of the stress on the plague doctor. And let's see. Quarantine is still pretty good. Yeah, I think I'll do that, and then we'll probably be good health-wise. And that takes care of the road. Campfire, alrighty. Not bad. That's fine. Do I want to chance it just in case there's a key over here? I think I do. Because I've got a lot of torchlight. The only thing I'm really worried about is the, okay, that, I mean, oh, fuck. Oh, okay, yeah, I'm worried about that. I am definitely worried about that. Shit, man, this is actually pretty bad. This is a lot of really awful shuffling of the party here. Oh my god. Can she Noxious Blast from the front? No, she can't do anything. She cannot do anything from that spot. Ow!
Blow to body and brain.
You gotta be kidding me. I gotta move. Wow, this sucks. Oh, this is so bad. I've gotta... What do I do here? Oh, shit. They completely fucked me up. Can I do this? If I can move the leper forward one more time, you're gonna die. Alright, we got one of them at least. I'm really worried about this. They are dealing so much fucking damage. I can Noxious Blast one, but I think I'd almost rather move her back. And then, oh yeah, then we can move her forward, or yeah, move him forward, and then we can group heal with her. Okay. That didn't really help that much, but it is, for the most part, our party fixed for next turn at least. And now, oh goodness. Oh goodness, we need to get a little lucky here, I think. Holy crap, man, this is getting really bad. Nice! Hell yeah! Good dodge! Excellent. Well done. We get to party heal again. And we get the Noxious Blast off, right? Got a blast! Wow, man, that freaked me the fuck out. Okay. I think we're good. I think we're gonna be okay now. He's gonna die next turn no matter what. That's probably back to death's door. Ooh, just a bit. Oh! Just missed it. One more hit point. They say one hit point doesn't make a difference. And by they, I mean I. And I was lying. That's okay. I probably should have gotten rid of stress there, but whatever. Self-heals. Yay. My god. Alright, well, we got some stuff. I really should not go into this last room. It's just a bad idea. Yeah, I'm getting out of here. But what if there's a key? What if I had to walk all the way back with no food? Then I'd die!
Wholesome marine life can flourish. If indeed there is such a thing.
I'm pretty sure I might die. And like, it's not even worth it to get to the secret room without a key anyway, so... You know! What are we gonna do? Up to level 3 for these 3 at least. You're gonna need some power leveling, but that's okay. You got wasting sickness. Not a big deal. We made it through. The cove complete.
Of rare and exotic injuries makes this place perfect for the study of suffering.
And the caregivers' convention is in town. Hooray! That's awesome. All right, let's go do this before I forget. So clearly, we're gonna go ahead and throw McCault in here. Get rid of the wasting sickness. Very nice. What can we do? What can we lock in? What can we get rid of? There's obviously some very expensive stuff to dispose of here. Warren's Phobe, maybe even chief among them. Let's see, Dismas, Flagellant, Known Cheat, I can leave those locked in. Thingophobia is pretty bad, I could get rid of that on Tournai. Let me see here, Bad Gambler, bad. Okay, so there's... Tournai is a chief suspect. Misses the Spot is pretty bad too, I do want to get rid of this. And then Evasive is not a bad quirk to lock in either. I also like Quick Reflexes. You know what? I might do this. Quick Reflexes is really good. I think I'm going to lock that in here. Extra Speed. Get rid of that. Awesome. All right. Great stuff for the Hellion. Sickly. Weak Grip doesn't really matter on her. Zoophobia is pretty bad. No really great positive quirks there, though. She's feeling pretty awful. Although I can leave those locked in, I just remembered. Fear of Eldritch sort of sucks. Ooh, she's got Quick Reflexes as well. Let's do that. Bam, and well, let's get one of the locked in ones, maybe. Which one of these makes her steal stuff? I don't think it matters. I think I'd rather get rid of Fear of Eldritch, honestly. So let's do that. Alright, good stuff. Thanks for watching this episode of Darkest Dungeon. Hope you enjoyed it. Leave a like if you did as well. Appreciate that a lot. I'll see you next time.